Tonight, no chief of staff for President Trump. We are reporting Trump is still working to come up with a plan B after Nick Ayers left him at the altar, and the president is trying to spin the situation.
We have a lot of people that want the job chief of staff, so we'll be seeing what happens. Over a period of a week or two, or maybe less, we'll announce who it's going to be. But we have a lot of people that want the position.
Okay, so far, plenty of people, though, have run away from the job, including the Treasury Secretary, Steve Mnuchin, and Budget Director Mick Mulvaney. Now, according to the Washington Post, yet a new name. Quote, Trump aides mentioned Rick Santorum as a contender after he was spotted with the president at Saturday's Army-Navy football game in Philadelphia. They noted Santorum's political skills and populist conservative ideology could make him a contender. Out front now, Rick Santorum, former Republican senator and presidential candidate who's also a CNN senior political commentator. All right, let's get straight to it. Senator, good to have you with me. Did it come up at the game?
Thank you.
Would you take the job?
It's an honor even to be considered. I think it's a great job, and I know that there are a lot of good people out there. The bottom line for me is just really like Nick Ayers. I mean, my family situation really doesn't allow me to do that right now. I would, again, be honored to do it at some point in time, maybe, but at this point, it just doesn't fit for me and my family. And so the answer right now would be no.
Honored, but no. I mean, look, here's the thing, Rick, I got to say, you know, you're someone who has all the expertise needed, right? You know how to deal with Congress. You know how to, you know, deal with the chief executive. You know how to manage a staff. You've done all of these things, right? You're the kind of guy that he needs to have. And yet, he has said some terrible things about you, right? Nasty, downright nasty things, right? I mean, I'll play one of them, okay? It's nasty. I say that up front. Here he is.
Okay.
Rick Santorum was a sitting senator who, in re-election, lost by 19 points. To my knowledge, the most in the history of this country for a sitting senator to lose by 19 points. It's unheard of. Then he goes out and says, oh, okay, I just lost by the biggest margin in history. Now I'm going to run for president. Tell me, how does that work?
And he was nastier on Twitter again and again and again, right? You're not a team player. You're desperate. You have as much chance of being the GOP nominee as Rosie O'Donnell, which God knows we know what he thinks about her. I mean, my question to you is, Rick, you're sitting here, you're being so gracious and classy. Oh, you know, I want to put my family first. Yeah. But
yeah,
he's not
well,
been
you play that
way
clip.
To you.
Well, hold on. I mean, you play that clip. But I actually called him after I saw that clip. And I reviewed it with him, and we had a very lengthy conversation. And in the end, he said, you know what, you know, I understand, you know, why you're doing what you're doing, and it makes sense to me. And you know, I won't use that line of attack ever again. And he never did. And so, you know, a lot of it is it's just you have to be upfront with people. You can't just let these things go. And you know, Trump doesn't. He fires back. I fire back in a different way. I just, you know, call the person up and say, well, let me give you my side of the story. And I can say he was very gracious. We actually, after that point, had a very positive relationship. And in fact, continues today. I have a very good relationship with Donald Trump. And when I saw him at the Army-Navy game, he was great to me. I had two of my boys there with me. He couldn't have been nicer with them. That's a side of Donald Trump that I don't think people see very often.
Yeah.
And because he is so confrontational, but he's also someone that you can sit down and you can reason with and you know, find accommodation. And that's one of the reasons I think hopefully someone really strong and that has the political talent will take this job as chief of staff. And I think you'd be surprised if the chemistry works well. It may be a very good fit and good for the country.
Well, you're saying, but, you know, that person is not going to be you. Who do you think would be good that would take the job?
I'm not going to throw out names. I don't know. No one's called me and told me that they're interested, and I have no idea who's in, who's out, and I don't want to put up names for the media to say, oh, here's another person that doesn't want the job, because I don't know whether they want the job or not. So all I know is that it's a great position. It's something that is a very important position in every administration, and I hope someone who it's right for them and their family and their time of life to do
Why
it, I hope they step up and serve the public.
Then? Why aren't people jumping at it? Nobody's.
I don't think we know whether they are or not. I mean, I don't know.
And you want to be with your family. Nick Ayers wants to be with his family. I mean, I'm not saying these are excuses. I know your deep commitment to your family, but I am saying nobody is stepping up here and saying, come on, let it be me.
I think there's some, from what I've heard, I haven't talked to anybody in the race, but I've heard several people are lobbying pretty hard for this position. So I don't think that's accurate to suggest that there's nobody who wants this. I think there are lots of folks out there who think they could do a good job, and the president has to find the right fit.
And do you have any idea who those people are who are lobbying hard? I know you're not going to give names, but I mean, are they the depth of qualifications and ability that someone like you would bring to it?
The people I've heard are very solid and would be good choices.
All right. Well, let's hope that one of them will do it and take it, because this country needs a good person in that spot. Thank you very much, Rick Santorum.